On this edition of One Championship Weekly, One Championship began the year with explosive martial arts action. One, A New Tomorrow in Bangkok, Thailand, featured an epic Muay Thai rematch with a world title on the line. You're watching One Championship Weekly. An unforgettable world championship rematch kicked off the new year in Bangkok. The night was headlined by the one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon, who defended his belt against the man he originally claimed it from, former one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Jonathan Haggerty. The result was an emotionally driven rematch of non-stop Muay Thai action.
He
wants you to get emotional, he wants you to fight him, he wants you to bring out your war instincts where you're not comfortable, but I'm gonna stick off my jab, stick off my teeth, and frustrate him, and hopefully we'll catch him with what we've been working on. Don't get stuck in there, don't fall for his game plans when he's sitting there banging on his chin. Sometimes simplicity is the master of the sport.
ความเร็วก็ระดับหนึ่งครับแล้วก็ลูกถีบเขาก็อันตรายครับเขาแบบเขาถีบได้ตลอดทำให้เราแบบเข้าทำได้ยากขึ้นแล้วก็วันนี้ก็แก้เกมอย่างดีครับก็จะไม่ประมาทเขาครับกว่าจะชนะเขาก็ได้ลูกได้นับถ้าไม่ได้นับครับผมว่าผมแพ้เหมือนกันครับ
I think that will play on his mind a little bit.Knowing that he's hit me with his best shot, he's knocked me down, I got back up.
อย่างที่ตั้งเป้าหมายก็คืออยากจะน็อกแฮกเกอร์ตี้ลงมาให้ได
้ Let's take a look at this instant classic in round 3.
He is staring down a 10-8 opening round where he got knocked down and possibly a 10-9 second round for Rodtang. Good jab there from Haggerty. Rodtang forcing him back against the ropes. Haggerty doesn't want to go there. Dump from Rodtang, nicely executing. Haggerty needs to get to that teep kick. Needs those elbows. Hooking punches from Rodtang. Haggerty calls him forward. That's usually what Rodtang does to opponents. Is he going to try and open up the ego now of Rodtang? We haven't seen Rodtang slap his face or pound his chest or play to the audience yet. It's been a much more tame Rodtang, though it's been a very aggressive Rodtang.
This is where Haggerty's got to be careful. He can't engage in these types of exchanges with Rodtang, where he gets pushing backwards, because that's how he lost his footing, got knocked down in the fourth round last time. He has to keep his footwork going, utilize those shots. There's that downward elbow that you were calling for, Michael.
Going for the collarbone cracker. There's a little shot from Rodtang. Haggerty having words with Elias Dilopsis. The referee. Maybe a thumb or something in the eye of Haggerty. Some injury time being called here as the doctor takes a look at the eye of Jonathan Haggerty. Haggerty, I feel, is trying to enter into the mental space of Rodtang here in the third. He wants Rodtang's ego to open up so Rodtang will maybe expose himself, maybe leave himself open and make a mistake. There it is, a thumb in the eye. Off the left hand, accidentally, of course, from Rodtang. Had Rodtang up in his face in the second round. Rodtang wanting Haggerty to come forward on him. Haggerty refusing. He wants Rodtang to come forward on him. He wants to bait Rodtang. Hope that Rodtang will make a mistake, will slip up, will leave himself exposed. Haggerty on the outside. Rodtang about to up the aggressor meter, it looks like. Good right hand there, jaw rattler from Haggerty. Another one there from the Brit. Rodtang backs him off, body shot, belly button through the back, liver shot, down again. Man. It's deafening in here. The second time Haggerty's been dropped with a liver shot and he's also cut. Front kick. He gets put on his backside. Here comes Rodtang, here comes the power. Boom to the body again. Referee calls time. Is it a mouth guard dislodged? It is.
Haggerty's got to be careful at this point. He's getting sucked into that exchange with Rodtang. He's got to move. Get on that bicycle. Do not play with this dangerous, dangerous game with Rodtang.
Rodtang going for the finish, backs off Haggerty again. They are two 22-year-olds, and now you see Rodtang's ego coming into play. The beating of the chest, the slapping of the face, that's what Haggerty wanted. That's the Rodtang Haggerty said he prepared for. Now let's see if he finds an opening. A jumping knee doesn't get through. Here comes Rodtang. The power, the power, the power, the power, the punishment. Haggerty down for a second time in the round. If he goes down once more in this round, it's over.
He's got 32 seconds
to survive. If he goes down once more, it's over in this round. Here comes Rodtang. Rodtang, 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 Rodtang. It's a meltdown as Rodtang puts the bang in Bangkok tonight. Have a look at this, a man on a demolition mission, bang to the liver, then to the temple, goes the liver again, the onslaught, the barrage. This is the tank at his finest. This is the Iron Man, all over and smothering Haggerty. Third knockdown in the round, all over. Have a look at the onslaught, 4 ounce gloves. One of the hardest hitters in the combat world going to your body like that. Glancing left, powerful right to the orbital.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Elias Dolepsis, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 39 seconds in the third round for your winner by way of technical knockout! And still one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon!
Rodtang Jitmuangnon is on another planet. He entered the Matrix when he jumped that sweep, and then he went absolutely bananas. A rampaging beast of a martial artist to get the three knockdown finish on Jonathan Haggerty in the third round. The rain of gold around the Impact Arena in Bangkok. The rain of gold continues for the Iron Man, the tank, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Coming up after the break, two sport, one world champion Stamp Fairtex continues her mixed martial arts campaign. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. Two sport, one world champion Stamp Fairtex continued her mixed martial arts journey in her quest to become the first ever three-sport, one world champion. Standing in her way was Wushu champion Pooja Tomar.
Pooja เนี่ยเป็นคนแข็งแรงค่ะแล้วก็ที่หนูดูคือเขาเป็นคนที่เก่งเรสลิ่ง
ฮะมุจิบอกได้คีสแตมป์के पास दो टाइटल है किकबॉक्सिंग और मुए थाई में वो बहुत ज़्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग है तो मैं कोशिश कर रही हूँ कि मैं ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा फाइट को बीजेजे किप्स पे खेलूँ
หนูคิดว่าพูจาน่าจะทดสอบหนูเรื่องเรสลิ่งแล้วก็กราวเกมค่ะหนูคิดว่าการยืนสู้หนูจะได้เปรียบค่ะแล้วก็ถ้าเป็นวงในในการปั้มของมวยไทยหนูคิดว่าหนูก็ได้เปรียบค่ะ
มุจิบอสเย่จานะและเล่นนะอัพนา 100% เต็มนะStamp को मैं best of luck बोलती हूँ और मैं उनकी बहुत respect भी करती हूँ बहुत अच्छी fight करती हूँ
Pooja be fit you fight my hometown I will win
on the one fantasy game the world's largest martial arts fantasy game on the one super app an overwhelming 94% of fans tipping a win for Stamp Fairtex But Pooja Toma, as we said earlier, is capable of the upset. She did so against Priscilla Hertati Lumbangol in Priscilla's backyard. Can she derail the hype of Stamp Fairtex in Stamp's backyard here in Bangkok? Stamp Fairtex, world Muay Thai champion, world kickboxing champion, has her sights set on becoming a world mixed martial arts champion. Pooja Toma will want to test her wushu striking against the Muay Thai of Stamp. Stamp has the height, has the reach. Pooja Toma's got to get off those side kicks and those rapid-fire hand combinations. Stamp taking her time, seeing what the Indian is made of, testing her mettle.
Stamp Fairtex predicts a head kick KO of Pooja Toma, and she's starting to set that up now, but that was a beautiful little catch. Redirect puts Stamp Fairtex on her back, but she pops right back up. Pooja Toma needs to keep doing that. She needs to put Stamp down, make her work. Oh, she gives up her back as she tried to sweep right there. She tried to catch and sweep, but she gives up her back, and now Stamp is on her back looking for that rear naked choke.
Can Stamp Fairtex sink a sub on Pooja Toma in the opening round? She wants to find the rear naked. Got the hooks in here, Stamp Fairtex. She'll work for it slowly.
Pooja Toma's got to defend that left arm of Stamp Fairtex. She can't let her get that arm out, because then she's going to be able to lace up the rear naked choke and apply that squeeze. Right now, the arm, the right arm of Sam Fairtex is still on the chin, so it's not quite a choke yet. You can still squeeze on both sides of the artery and still finish, but that's a high-level choke, and I don't know if Sam Fairtex has that type of capability, but if she keeps working on it, she could start to slowly inch that arm underneath the chin of Pooja Toma.
Stamp Fairtex trying to lock the figure four around the body to no avail, though. This is the fourth mixed martial arts contest for Stamp Fairtex. She's 3-0. Pooja Toma comes in 4-3. The four-time national wushu champion still has the two-sport world champion on her back. Here comes Stamp! This crowd going bananas! Every time she lands something, they scream for Stamp Fairtex. Stamp in control. Gonna get the full mount. Yes, she does. Drops the ground and pound. Stamp Fairtex choosing her mark. Trying to open her up to land the right hand. Stamp taking her time, showing tremendous composure.
Stamp was a little high in that mount and enabled Pooja Toma to squeak out the backside. Now she's attempting to go for that leg. Good defense so far by Stamp Fairtex as she's able to sit up, posture up, grabs the back of the head. Watch those right hands start to come.
The evolution of Stamp Fairtex has been phenomenal over the last 18 months. Look at this again. Top position on Toma, dropping the elbows from a vertical position. Spins around Stamp Fairtex. It's all one-way traffic. Takes her back again. It's deafening. Stamp Fairtex, a house on fire. And Pooja Toma gets onto her back. Stamp Fairtex has her all tied up with no place to go, taking the punishment. Going to try and flatten her out again.
Gifts wrapping a few submissions by extending those arms like that. She's got to create some kind of scrambles, because right now she's given up bad position after bad position.
Toma not defending. Referee Olivia Koss straight on top of the action. Here comes Stamp trying to finish her. Is Olivia Koss going to stop it? Toma not defending. Stamp continues to punish her. Smack bang to the kisser. Smack bang between the eyes. The left hands. The power. Now the right hand switch. Pooja Toma in a whole lot of bother. She's been flattened out again. They'll need a spatula to get her off the canvas. Pooja Toma nowhere to go. Olivia Koss may stop it. The elbows. The elbows. The good night, Irene. Stamp Fairtex goes 4-0.
She looks good in a lot of these grappling exchanges, able to maintain positions. You can see Pooja Toma tried to reap out the leg, but in doing so, she gave up her back. And that was pretty much the beginning of the end. Look at Poja Tomar offering up her neck, saying you can take it if you want, but she didn't want it. She just wanted to sit there and drop bombs on her, raining in shot after shot. Eventually, Olivier Cost had to jump in. He saw enough, called a halt to that one.
The most dangerous woman on the planet, Stan Fairtex, kickboxing world champion, Muay Thai world champion, now 4-0 in mixed martial arts with three finishes. Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 27 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Stamp Fairtex!
A massive ovation for the wonderful, the superb, the sublime Stamp Fairtex. 4-0 in mixed martial arts. The one Super Series Muay Thai and kickboxing world champion. She is conquering everyone they put in front of her.
After the break, a look ahead to Manila with One Fire and Fury. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. One Championship heads back to Manila with an epic lineup. One Fire and Fury is headlined by an exciting matchup of world champions. One Strawweight World Champion Joshua Pacio defends his belt against former One Strawweight World Champion Alex Silva. Let's take a look at the moment Silva first claimed the biggest prize of his career when he faced off against the then world champion Yoshitaka Naito. We join the bout in the fifth and final round.
This crowd here in Bangkok on the edge of their seats. 5 minutes remaining.
Fighters ready?
Can he smell championship gold, Alex Silva? Or will Naito power back here in the fifth and final and get the victory? Big outside leg kick from Silva to open up the final round. Let's see if there's a bit more gusto, a bit more mustard behind the champion, Naito. Outside leg kick again from Silva. That's the exclamation mark. Left hook misses the target. Time is ticking down for Yoshitaka Naito. But this is the round he said he'd win it in. Do you think Naito expected Silva to be more drained by this time in the contest, Mitch?
I think so, but you can still see the heat at which Silva is throwing these shots. He's still trying to end it in the fifth round with big power. So we're not seeing the conditioning really be that big of an effect, but this is where I like to see Naito. This is where he's starting to excel. This has been his best position of the entire match, having Silva pressed up against the cage and grinding on him. I'd like to see him throw more shots in this position, but this grappling of Silva makes it very difficult.
Six submission wins, one KO, undefeated 12-0 Yoshitaka Naito. But the strawweight champion has had a hard time so far against a challenger at the peak of his powers, who has surprised all and sundry with a sublime stand-up performance.
The grappling of Naito, this wrestling, this wall wrestling that we're seeing from him, the way that he's sucking the legs away from Silva is very impressive. Silva's not able to get a base on him. You can see him keep trying to slide his legs out so he can posture up and start to stand back up. But the way Naito is controlling those legs is really impressive. He's consistently sucking the legs away and controlling the hips of Silva. Now Silva's starting to work from the guard. Now he's starting to threaten with a possible triangle here.
Yoshitaka Naito looking to improve his position. Foot on hips here from Silva. Naito staying on top. There's the butterfly guard from the challenger. Short popping left hand there from the champion, Yoshitaka Naito. Now he might try a guillotine. The fifth and final round is where he said he'd choke him out. And Silva looks safe here, Mitch.
Silva's got an arm in, so he's defending quite well. Very hard to finish a black belt of Alex Silva's capacity at this. Now Silva's going for the takedown, turning the tables on the champion.
Single leg from Silva. Now he has top position. Naito looking to get back to his feet.
Look at Silva taking a page out of Naito's playbook, trying to suck the legs away from the cage so he can advance his takedown. But look at the champion walking back up.
The Thai audience who have been raised on striking are really embracing this grappling contest in the fifth and final round, Mitch. Everyone oohing and ahhing here inside the Impact Arena.
I think that's because what everybody expected. They expected to see a grappling showcase put on here today. But we're not seeing that. We're seeing so much beautiful striking and Muay Thai here in Bangkok that I think the crowd is anticipating a grappling battle.
We are seeing a very varied martial arts contest. Overhook on the right arm there from Yoshitaka Naito, the champion, who's got 1 minute 30 remaining to try and retain his strap. He shoots in for a double. Nice defense there from Little Rock.
He immediately goes after that single leg, trying to suck the legs away from the wall. Yep, pull him away, trying to advance the position. He's got 75 seconds to sink in his prediction of a rear naked choke to retain the belt.
Little Rock glances towards his corner. They're barking instructions at him. Posts up on his left arm now. What's Naito looking to do here, Mitch?
He's trying to get the back. He's trying to get Silva's back away from the cage so he can take his back. Oh, he's about to do it. Silva's trying to get the overhook on the side, trying to keep Naito away from taking his back.
Naito wants the back. He wants the rear naked choke. That's what he predicted yesterday. Fifth round rear naked choke.
Oh, he's got the back. He's almost got the back. Look at Silva. The Wizard is the only thing that's preventing Naito from fully taking his back. Silva's got to press his back up against the cage so Naito can't sneak around. We got 30 seconds.
Half a minute remaining now. Time is ticking down. It's been a gripping contest for the world title. Can Naito take the back? Can he try and find a choke? 15 seconds now. We're going to go down to the wire on this one. A knee there from Silva. Naito hoping for a low single. Swinging for a knockout, punches Silva. Outside leg kick, fittingly. It ends an amazing contest. Has Alex Silva done enough to capture the world title? We will find out soon. Wherever you're watching around the world, how did you score it? Look at the nerves on Alex Silva's family. I glanced across at them during that final round. They were covering their eyes, Mitch. They could hardly watch. My word, this one is going to be interesting. What a contest. What a championship match.
You saw the champion rise to the occasion in the fourth and fifth round. We saw him really put on a tremendous display of the martial arts spirit as he continually grinded on Silva, working him, hammering him, softening him up. But you have to look back at rounds 1, 2, and 3 and the striking superiority of the challenger, landing that leg kick over and over again, the big shots. Michael, your call. Who do you got?
I've got to go Little Rock Alex Silva for mine. Those leg kicks and the superb striking prove the difference in my mind. But let's see how the judges are going to score it. In the background there, you see the CEO and chairman of ONE Championship, Chatri Sitjotong, who will present the world title. Let's go to Dominic Lau to find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of intense battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner. And new ONE Strawweight World Champion, Alex Silva!
The dream comes true! Chatri Sitjotong, the chairman and CEO of ONE Championship, hands the gold to Alex Silva, who is overcome by emotion here in Bangkok.
ONE Championship returns to Manila, Philippines on the 31st of January with ONE Fire and Fury. The event is headlined by an exciting matchup of world champions. ONE Strawweight World Champion Joshua Pacio defends his belt against former ONE Strawweight World Champion Alex Silva in an outstanding striker versus grappler bout. And on the 7th of February is ONE Warriors Code in Jakarta, Indonesia, the main event bout for the inaugural ONE Featherweight Muay Thai World Title, features Muay Thai superstar Pet Mor Khatpet Indy Academy facing Russian powerhouse Jamal Yusupov. Check your local listing. Thank you for watching ONE Championship Weekly.